thinking of shaping protocols. According to American Endodontic Association, the most difficult cases are the curved one, especially when we have like 30 degrees or even more curved angle in the part, some part of the canal. The best classification of this is the Schneider classification, and the easy cases are when the angle between the main canal axis and apical line is smaller than 10 degrees. In that cases, you can use any available system on the market. You can use also a bigger taper because it is doable and quite safe to work with the class 1 Schneider classification canals. The medium difficulty is when this angle is between 10 degrees and 25 degrees, and above 25 degrees are the extremely hard to shape in a proper and easy way. The angle is not only the one issue that we should concern about. The second one is also the radius, because both the angle and the radius of the curvature can give us some difficulties during the shaping protocol. If the angle is bigger and the smaller is the radius of the curvature, the case is more complex than when the radius is bigger. So it actually curves in one particular point, and this is the critical point for every shaping rotary file, and we should check with the hand files if the canal is curved or not. We shouldn't say, comparing endodontic files to cars, that there is the best car in the world, because it depends what we expect from the car. If we expect speed, some Formula One bullet will be the best car. If we expect capacity, some kind of the truck will be the best car. If we expect or want to ride with some not some curvy roads, we need some SUV or Jeep or something. This is the same situation with the root canals. We cannot shape every canal with the same system, with the same protocols. The easy cases, we can shape with the same system and stick to it. But when we sculpt the canal with the hand file and realize the canal is curved and the curvature is severe, we should think about what would be the best solution, and I will try to describe you some solution for curved canals today. One of the most important thing is the radiographic evaluation prior to root canal treatment, because we can see if there is a curvature or not. Actually, the 2D radiographic evaluation with the RFG's or X-rays are not the best way nowadays. If we had CBCT, it would be better, but it is not so common. In Poland also, it's very expensive to buy the CBCT for the office. Some huge clinics, they do have the CBCTs, and I refer my patients in extreme cases to do the small CBCT only of the tooth I want to check, and to get the proper strategy for the shaping protocols. And here you can see the upper second molar, which was a bit curved and has some additional lateral canals at the apical part. The very important step in shaping protocols, especially curved canals or double curved canals, is the first step is preparing the endodontic cavity and straight line access. It is extremely important. Without straight line access, it might be impossible to shape the canal to the full working length. That's why I will describe some necessary tools I use in my practice. I always want to share some practical knowledge with the participants, not only the statistics, the tables, just what I'm doing every day in my practice and how it works with my hands. So it's more clinical concentrated than theoretical concentrated lecture. So from the book Germans, barcode, score and circle. I took these pictures while they are preparing the endodontic cavity. They explain it as an endodontic cavity. It should be slightly opened to the occlusal surface that we can clearly see the whole chamber and to see, can locate exactly the orifices of the canal. And this is the stage that we have properly opened the endodontic cavity. We can locate and scout the orifice of the canal, but you can see there is some kind of the triangle of the dentine covering the orifice of the canal. And it is difficult here in this point. We got the triangle of the dentine that if we are not remove this triangle, the file is already prebanded from the orifice till the end. And sometimes there is a problem with establishing the full working length. When we remove this triangle of dentine, here the authors show us with the gate split and burst, but we got also some openers in nighttime files, if they are more flexible than stainless steel gate split and burst. We create a straight line access and end file curved actually only in the real curvature of the tooth. There are less stress, less tense during the shaping protocols, and the risk of broken rotary file when we create a proper straight line access is not so high. The best file I use for opening, creating the endodontic cavity is diamond covered burr in this shape with non-cutting teeth. So it's very safe, we are not destroying the bulk chamber floor, we can just close our eyes and draw the black triangle when we are talking about the molars, because molars are the most difficult endodontic treatment. One more time, the straight line access create us and give us the possibility to enter the file that curves only in the actual curvature, and clinically you can see on this picture. This is the pre-op. This is the extension of the corner with the hand files. This is with eccentric enlargement with the gate split and burst. And this is why we are removed this part of the dentine covering the isthmus, connecting the mesial canals in the lower molars. It is important to uncover the whole bulk chamber floor, because sometimes there is an additional canal in this isthmus, and if we don't cover it, we don't open it, remove this dentine, we are not able to locate this additional canal, and we might have some problems with this endodontic treatment. While we are working with the end files, we can create some mistakes during this procedure, especially when we are not pre-bending the stainless steel end files, and while we are working with a quite stiff and big size of the end files. For me, the big size starts at 25, according to ISO standardization. Number 25, 30, 35, 40, they are quite stiff, and they can create the strip perforation on the internal curvature of the canal. They can also create a thing called elbow. It is the situation when the main constriction of the canal is not at the end of the canal, but a few millimeters above. And if in that situation, we will have some clinical problems, especially with the obturation, where we are using some cold lateral condensation. We will not be able to condense the cold good aperture here. If we are working with the thermically activated good aperture, we will be able to fill it. But the third, we can create also a mistake called zip. Of course, we can create some mistakes using the rotary files as well. But I will try to show you how to work with the rotaries in two different concepts while mechanical shaping. So the two main concepts that I'm using in my practice is the first one is the single length technique. The second one is crown down technique. The single length means that the rotary file, each rotary file from the set goes directly to the full working length, one after another. The crown down technique means that we first we are using the bigger sizes of bigger taper files that are entering the canal, not to the full working length, and then we are switching to the smaller files that are entering deeper in the canal, and the smallest files are the first that reach the full working length. And I use crown down technique in extreme cases, and I divide also the canal into two parts and shape the first part and then I'm concentrating about shaping the last apical part of the canal. Also, we can have some differences between the alloys, the classic nitride alloys, the M-wire alloys, or the control memory alloy, and they will also give us some more possibilities, and we can choose between the systems to shape extremely cases. Single length, as I said, it's an easy procedure, easy to learn how to work with it, but it is good for easy and moderate curves. In very curved canals, it might be difficult to reach the full working length, not with the first file, but with the second or third from the set. It might be very difficult, and the most common mistake that we can have here is the file breakage around the curvature. So we want to avoid breaking the file. So I use the single length technique as a basic technique for easy cases, because it's quick and it's easy, and we can work very well and very quickly. And one of the most popular on the market, I think in India as well, is the ProTaper, maybe ProTaper Next, that it is single length based technique system that we can create from the entrance, the orifice of the canal, then we measure the full working length with the 10 size K file, and then we are entering every single file to the full working length. As I said, easy cases it's okay. In more curved, we need to be more sophisticated in our shaping protocol and use some other techniques. I don't recommend this technique in curved canals. As you can see on this preoperative X-ray, this tooth, the upper second molar, even on this X-ray, it doesn't look that we might have some problems. That's why I decided to use the ProTaper Next and the single length technique. But I also check the X-ray examination with the file that I'm scouting the canal. The first file that I introduce into each canal will give us the information: is the X-ray correct? Is the canals are easy or not? If they are not easy, we will have a problem with entering the canal with the K file size number 10. Or when we remove it from the canal, we can see that it's pre-curved, pre-bent, and give us the more details about the root canal anatomy. So in this case, it was quite easy. The curves are moderate. There was an interesting anatomy because there was a distal buccal canal that merged in the apical part, the palatal canal. So it's not so common among the molars. But in more complex cases than this, I recommend, as I said, the crown down technique because it's much more safer. We are enlarging the coronal part first. We are doing the coronal reflaring with the files, and then we are entering in the most difficult part while the upper part of the canal is already shaped and prepared. We also create the straight line access, and it is better to use smaller files and smaller tapered files working around the curvatures. I recommend 4% tapered files, sometimes even 2% tapered files, just to enlarge the canal in the apical part underneath the curvature. And I
mostly use the AmbuStar sequence. There is a file set, and every single one is from the night eye, classic night eye alloy. And the first one is the biggest one, the second is the smaller one, third is the smaller, and every next file is smaller than the previous one. And in complex spaces, I love these two files because they are 25 on the tip and 4% paper, or even 20 and 4% paper. So they're very flexible, and we can shape the canal around the curvature. They are designed to work with the crown down. We can also use this system in normal cases, not only in extreme cases. So we are doing the coronal enlargement with the bigger files going down, and the first rotary file that reached the full working length is the smallest one, 2004. In normal cases, when we reach this file to the full working length, it is not the size of choice that we can finish the preparation. It's too small. So we can go back to file number 4, or even after that go back to file number 3 to enlarge the canal. So we can do the step back with the rotary files as well, while we reach with the smallest one the working length. After that, it doesn't matter if you're working with a single length or if we are working with the crown down technique, we should check if the preparation size, the shaping size at the end of the canal is correct. And to check the rotary files, we need the hand files, because there is a marriage between hand files and rotary files. We cannot throw out all our hand files because we want some rotary system. The hand files we need them to prepare the canal for the rotary system and to check if the rotary system shape in a proper way the root canal. And the best files to check it are the night eye hand files, 2% paper, because rotary files are from night eye alloy. They are working around the curvatures in a specific way, and while we are trying to check the rotary night eye file with the stainless steel hand file, it can give us some false information, because the stainless steel file can lock in the curvature and give us false information about the apical preparation. If we are checking the rotary preparation with the night eye 2% hand file, we entered this night eye hand file to the full working length, and we are trying to remove it in a very delicate way. If it's spinning around, that means the apical part is anatomically bigger than the size we finished the preparation, and we should consider how to enlarge the apical preparation in apical size. If we enter the hand file night eye to the full working length and try and delicately rotate it, and it doesn't want to rotate, it just springs in the canal, that is the information for us that we can finish the apical preparation. The apical width is okay with this size. This is the clinical movie. I entered the 35 size night eye K file and tried to rotate it. You can see that it doesn't want to rotate. Of course, if I push the pressure, I will rotate all kind of the hand file, but it is gently movement with the fingers. And when I pushed, entered the canal with the size 30 night eye K file, it rotates. It means size 30 is not enough. We should consider enlargement of the apical part. In easy cases, we can use some rotary files, 4% paper with bigger apical sizes, like for example, Buff system. There are four files with 4% paper and sizes 35 to 50, but it is only in quite easy or moderate canals. In very curved canals, I would suggest to enlarge the apical part with O2 paper. So we can use the hand files, night eye, or rotary hand files, 2% paper, just to work around the curvature and to enlarge the apical part. This is the case that I prepared some time ago. We can see here quite big collision. The coronal part of the tooth was very destroyed. I rebuilt it first, then I prepared the canal. And you can see there's some moderate curvature here, but I was able to reach the full working length with size 40.04 to finish the preparation. And when we see on the preoperative x-ray that they are visible, some periapical lesions, we need to figure it out how to enlarge in the safest way the apical part to have a better disinfection. If we don't have a periapical lesion, it is the primary treatment, we can be more conservative, more saving more tissues in the apical part, and we can create a smaller shaping protocol to finish the protocol at a smaller size. And you can see here is the I think 2 years checkup, and here is the 5 years checkup. I put the post in here and the porcelain fused metal crown, and it works well. But it was the moderate curvature, that's why I decided to use the bigger size with 4% taper. In cases like this, when on the preoperative picture x-ray, we can see that the mesial buccal root, normally it should have two canals, mesial buccal 1, mesial buccal 2, and it's quite curved in the apical part. I check with the scouting files, and the scouting files give me that information. They are curved, there were two canals merging in the apical part. So I decided to choose other rotary conception, other conception for the shaping protocol to make it easier and safer, not to break the canal just behind the curvature. This is how it looks after the preparation. The two canals are merging here, and from the different angle, you can see this is the MB1, the MB2 merging here, and this is almost like maybe not 90 degrees, but it's quite curved, and it was not easy to shape it directly to the full working length with the rotaries. So I decided, you can see the coronal pre-flaring here with the rotary files first, and then around the curvature I work with 4% taper, crown down technique, and enlarge this apical part with 2% taper only. So the 2% taper rotary files, like 9x2 files, they are very flexible because there's not the taper is like the hand files, and they are working in rotary motion, so it is easy to put them around the curvature. They are S files in the cross section, so they are one of my favorite just to enlarge the apical part. That 2% taper file will work only here, not in the in the curvature. If we finish the case, if we use the 4% taper prior to this 2% taper. This case requires some approach that will give us the best possibility to disinfect the apical part, because we can see periapical lesion on the preoperative x-ray. We can clearly see the triangle of dentin that is here nearby the orifice, so we need to remove it, create a straightened access, and then we will be able to finish the proper preparation, 4% taper, and it was quite easy to gain the apical size 35 and 4% taper. So we can see the canal is curved, but we are able to do this if we are thinking and taking the strategy according to the canal. Sometimes we can even have some different strategies in the same tooth for the one root and for the one canal and for the another canal, because they might be completely different. So the question, what is the best rotary system, is not a proper question. There are no the best rotary system. The technique and the concept, the strategy is the best for this case. For the another case, completely different strategy will be better. We can have possible failures during root canal treatment according to the torsional loading or cyclic fatigue. And the torsional loading occurs if the file binds in the canal and the torque set on the handpiece is too high, and the micro motor is still rotating the file even if it winds in some point. That creates a huge stress and file break in the canal. So this is the end that winds in the some part of the canal, and torque is still spinning around the rest of the file. While we are working with the crown down technique, it is not so easy to bind the file because the coronal part is shaped in the first way, then we are concerning about the apical part. The second mistake is according to the cyclic fatigue, and it is the result of continued forces being placed on an instrument that operate around the curvature. If the canal is more curved, we can have the possible of the bracket of the file is getting higher, and this is the best picture explaining this. This is the this is the file working around the curvature. From the inner side of the curvature, there is a compression of the file, and in the outer part of the same file, in the same point, with that tension. So the file should not work around the curvature, and we shouldn't stop it for 1 or 2 or 3 seconds. The file should move around all the time to move this point from one part to another, not to stay just in one point. It is called the packing motion with the rotary files, and the packing motion is quite safe, not to have the failures like here. This is the pre-operative x-ray that the patient was sent to my office, and I took the x-ray and I see 2 broken files. I was able only to remove 1 broken file from the MB canal, and I wasn't able to reach the another file, so I decided to bypass this broken file, and this is the 2 angles of the same x-ray after the shaping protocol and after operation. So this is the curved canal, and more difficult, more complex than curved canal is double curved canal. It's called S-shape because it looks like S letter, and this case, the S-shape cases, are for me the most challenging cases ever. I divide each S-shape canal into 2 parts and work around the first curvature in the first step, and then try to measure the full working length and finish the preparation around the second curvature. So I divided the preparation into 2 parts, and this is the case of the second upper premolar with 2 canals in S shape. This is how it looks after the preparation from one angle and another angle. So they are completely separate canals in S shape, and it was very difficult to keep their natural S shape and enlarge the canal, not to strain too much, not to remove the dentine tissue from the internal part of the curvature, because it is risky. We can create with the rotary files as well the strip perforation. That's why when we see the S-shaped canal, we should think about 4% taper files or even 2% taper files for the shaping protocol. 6% will be too stiff and can create the strip perforation. This is the funny movie I prepared for the lecture about my shaping protocol with classic or M-wire Nitai files. In a plastic block in S shape. As I said, I divide the protocol into 2 parts. First part is like 3 out of 4 of the full working length, and then the second one is just the enlargement of the apical part. And this is the funny movie. This is the plastic block. And here you can see the names of the files that I use for it. And now I'm working not on the full width, I'm enlarging the apical part and working around the first curvature. So we got a lot of instruments that I'm switching. This is the first file that entered the full working length. This is the second, size 10K file to the working length. Then I use path files from the my lever for the full working length. Now I use Protaper S1 from my lever. Then S2. Then I want to be more safe in the apical part, so I switch the single length to the ground down. So sometimes I even switch between conception, and this is the post-op and the pre-op, and when I cover one picture with another. So in cases like this, the shaping protocol looks like that. So I use, except the hand files, I use path files, I use protapers, I use ambassador files, and sometimes I use Nightlight 2 files to finish. So I switch almost 4 or 5 systems during one particular case, just to have these curves still persistent in natural way. And it is very, very difficult to have this this protocol. Sometimes I modify the protocol, and like 2 years ago, I have my first experience with controlled memory files. So it was the HyFlex from Container. It is the rotary files that have a controlled memory. We can pre-bend it, and it's still pre-bend. It still keep the shape like this. So they are extremely flexible. They can work easily around the curves in easiest way than this protocol with the normal classical Nightlight alloy. So I check how it works, and I decided to use these files sometimes as a finisher, or I prepare the whole canal with these files, but only in extreme cases. I don't use it for the normal regular cases. They are not aggressive at all. I like a little bit more aggressive file in normal cases than this. But in cases with a curved canal or double curve, this is one of the best in my practice. And they don't require a lot of experience. This is the picture of the students of the fifth year that finished this case with the HyFlexes. So let's say it was her first time with rotary, maybe second time with the rotaries, and she was able to create, to finish the case like this. I would like to present you the movie about shaping the S-shaped premolar with the HyFlexes. And we will also see that the obturation of this canal, if it's more complex, more curved, it's difficult. So you can just watch this movie. This is the premolar. One root is very short, second one is longer and in S shape. And I was using the HyFlexes as the manufacturer gave me the instructions, so I didn't modify anything. It is single length, not the crown down. I said, okay, let's try to do it single length. If I will see that I'm not able to finish it within this procedure, I will modify it during the procedure and finish with this crown down. I said, I will believe in the manufacturer and check if it's okay. So I was just entering the whole sequence of the endostars in the, of the HyFlexes. You can see that they are sometimes it goes and it's curved because it works in the curved canal. And you can also see here in the mirror the packing motion. That means that I'm moving all the time the file, not keeping it in one point, rotating around
the curvature. Next lecture is mine. So to whom I should be pendering?
Doing the packing motions one after another.
Do you have seats there in the front?
Checking and controlling.
Do we have seats to sit there in the front?
Under the microscope. the next file.
It's okay, I will come in.
Another canal. Then I'm doing the apical painting scene, so I'm trying to keep the apical part of the canal patient without any debris. Then when the debris that can lock the canal. I use another file from the set. It's 06 taper. So it's quite big taper, but according to the metallurgy, this allows us to use it. They are more flexible than the traditional nitide alloy. You can see like snake movement of the file. And I think it will be the last file. Then I'm doing the apical painting scene just before the final irrigation protocol and before the obturation. And you can also see the shape of the canal on the K file size number 10. Then after the final irrigation, I just measure and fit the master cones. I am working with the continuous wave of obturation, so it's I thermically activate the gutta-percha cone inside the canal with the hot plugger, and then I inject the gutta-percha to the rest of the canal. Now I place the master cone, and you can also see how the hot plugger tip is curved because of the S shape of the canal. The palatal canal was the easier, and the curved, double curved is this one. Activated, introduce the hot plugger tip 4 millimeters short than full working length. Then I inject the gutta-percha from the gun for the rest part of the canal. Compact it with the cold plugger. The same for another canal. And this is how the hot plugger tip is look like, and this is the post op. The first post op and a different angulation. So we can see there is a problem. The anatomy is very difficult, but I'm just keeping the manufacturer's advice how to work with that controlled memory, memory files. And I use it sometimes as a finisher, sometimes I use from the beginning till the end. So I would like to finish this presentation, and I would like you to have your mind open and choose the proper strategy for each canal. Don't bind to the producers, to the products, because they are changing all the time, all over the world. Just the strategy of the shaping protocol is good, but sometimes even with great instruments, huge knowledge and experience, we can just look at the preoperative x-ray and have a smile. You can look like, here it's from Zerodonto, it looks like a dancing teeth, and you can also see there is some broken file in the canal. But I think even the surgeon will have a huge problem to remove this tooth and all these roots. And I don't believe there is any rotary system or reciprocating system or whatever to fight with this double curve canal. So one more time, thank you for this presentation. I'm still sorry for the quality of it, but I hope you enjoyed. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and one more time you can check my cases on Facebook page of my blog perfendo.blogspot.com. Thank you for your time.